Hey y'all, my name is Nat. I hope you're having a terrific day today, and for this video we are doing the Finally Fall book tag. So it is finally fall and it is finally October, which is my favorite month because not only do we have Halloween, but it's also my birthday month. Got to get down all of my Halloween decorations. You guys can watch me decorate my room in my last reading vlog, which I'll link up here. We've been having a bit of a cold front in Texas lately. We actually were like only in the 70s today, so you know, fall weather. I broke out my haunted house t-shirt, put on a cardigan, and I am ready for this tag. I was tagged by the lovely Lady Jane Books. Definitely go check her out. She reads lots of horror books, so perfect booktuber to get into at this time of year. Let's start off with the question. In fall, the air is crisp and clear. Name a book with a vivid setting. For this one, I chose Truly Devious by Maureen Johnson. Not only are we in a decades-old school with a gorgeous campus and secret creepy passageways, but it's also in fall, so totally perfect time. And it's in Vermont, so you can actually see the seasons, unlike Texas. Next prompt. Nature is beautiful, but also dying. Name a book that is beautifully written, but also deals with heavy topics like loss or grief. For this one, I went with White Oleander by Janet Finch. This is such a heavy book that deals with abuse, murder, pedophilia, but at the same time is so beautifully written. The writing in this reads like prose or poetry. It's just so lyrical and flowery and gorgeous. However, this deals with, like I said, a lot of serious topics, and over time we have to watch as Astrid endures all of these terrible things and how she manages to come out on the other side, as well as separate herself from the idea she's thought about herself and her mother for so long. Next prompt. Fall is back to school season. Share a nonfiction book that taught you something new. For this one, I'm gonna go with Why We Buy, The Science of Shopping by Paco Underhill. I had to read this for my consumer behavior course in college. This dives into all the different psychology and marketing that goes behind the setup of a brick and mortar store. It was really interesting, and I still find myself thinking back to this book whenever I go into malls and considering like, oh well, this area probably doesn't get a lot of traffic because it's set up in such a way that is inconvenient to the customer. Yes, I'm aware. I'm a nerd. Next prompt. In order to keep warm, it's good to spend some time with people we love. Name a fictional family, household, friend group that you'd like to be a part of. I mean, obviously, the Bat family. Like, who do you think I am? Next prompt. The colorful leaves are piling up on the ground. Show us a pile of fall-colored spines. We're gonna see if I can do this without dropping them. Ooh, okay. Ooh. Yep, this is very precarious. So I have One of Us is Next by Karen M. McManus, The Sinister Mystery of the Mesmerizing Girl by Theodora Goss, Cemetery Boys by Aidan Thompson, Circe by Madeline Miller, The Dirt on Ninth Grave by Dorinda Jones, The Rules of Magic by Alice Hoffman, as well as The Curse of the Tenth Grave by Dorinda Jones. I had more, but I didn't trust my arm muscles to hold them all up. Next prompt. Fall is the perfect time for some storytelling by the fireside. Share a book wherein somebody is telling a story. For this one, I went with The Witch's Daughter by Paula Braxton. Anytime we are seeing the past timelines, we are actually seeing Elizabeth telling the story of her life to Tegan, who is a young girl she has recently taken under her wing and is considering teaching witchcraft. Next prompt. The nights are getting darker. Share a dark, creepy read. For this one, I had to go with Lock Every Door by Riley Sager. It was so weird and unsettling, sent shivers down my spine. You can watch me read and review this over at my Riley Sager video, which I will put in the cards up above. Next prompt. The days are getting colder. Name a short, heartwarming read that could warm up somebody's cold and rainy day. For this one, I went with Miss Marvel, No Normal by G. Willow Wilson, and I just thought this was such a pure and wholesome superhero story. It's almost a retelling of the classic Spider-Man origin, but with a new character who is diverse and different in her own way. In this, Kamala has a really hard time fitting in and doesn't like that she is so different from most of the other American teenagers at her school. However, she slowly comes to accept herself as well as her powers so she can help other people, and it's just so cute and sweet. I loved this one so much. Next prompt. Fall returns every year. Name an old favorite that you like to return to soon. For this one, I'm going with The Outsiders by Essie Hinton. I last read this in seventh grade. I've seen the movie a good few times since then, but I do actually want to reread it. I loved this story so much, and I still really enjoy the premise of it, but I want to actually read it and see if my experience holds up. I don't know when I'll get around to it, but hopefully soon. Next prompt. Fall is the perfect time for cozy reading nights. Share your favorite cozy reading accessories. For me, that has to be my favorite comfy sweatshirt, a cup of coffee, the comfy chair, and my tortilla blanket because I am the burrito. Finally, spread the autumn appreciation and tag some people. For this, I am going to be tagging Rosie Cockshut, Mare Reads, Sunny Luca, Catherine Zofree, The Bookish Potatoes, and The PM Reader. All right, y'all, so that is it. Thank you so much for coming to my channel today, guys. I really appreciate it. Make sure to hit like and subscribe down below. I come out with videos on Monday and Friday, but until then, I hope you continue to have a terrific day. Bye.